You know, only 3% of family businesses, family farming operations, make it to the next generation. There's a lot going wrong. There's some parts going right. But the reality is, so many farming operations are finding it difficult to have conversations with the next generation. How do they start those conversations? The young generation don't know how to start the conversation. And the older generation, the parents, are thinking, I don't want to open up a can of worms, so I'm going to leave that conversation alone. That's why 3% aren't making it, right? 3%, 97% failure rate. That is the problem. We need to have more conversations. I think the next generation needs to accelerate that conversation. They need to say to their parents, look, you're going to live a lot longer than your own parents. So if I just wait around and hang around the farm waiting for you to start this conversation, I could be waiting till you're in your 80s and your 90s, and I'll be in my 60s. So the young generation need to step up and say, look, I would like to own this farm one day. How can we have a conversation to start that process? I think a lot of young farmers are overwhelmed by the appreciation and the value of the farm. And so they look at their parents' farm and they think, my gosh, it's worth $3 million, $13 million, $30 million, $300 million. There's no way I'll ever be able to farm. The only way that I'm going to get this farm is if I hang around the farm long enough, put enough sweat equity into the business, and then when my parents die, I'll get it for free. Well, of course, you and I both know that there isn't enough sweat equity on the planet to pay for a $30 million farm. I talk about the next generation buying shares, and I'll tell you why it's important. It's important because if we don't pay full market value for those shares, then the family members, the brothers and sisters off the farm, are going to think that someone got something that they didn't deserve. And there's also a lack of innovation. When we gift businesses to the next generation, when they haven't actually purchased those businesses at full market value, often that next generation doesn't really have the permission to drive the innovation and make those hard business decisions to change the business. They often run the business exactly the way their parents or grandparents ran the farm. Well, you and I both know that farming is changing like crazy. The amount of innovation, both in finance and science, technology, change is the only thing that is going to stay the same. How can we start that transition so that it's slow and steady? I always say you can eat a cow one burger at a time. If a young farmer starts to borrow a little bit of money and buys one share and then uses the dividend, right, that one share produces, they can slowly accumulate more shares. All they need to do is get to 51%, then they have definitive control of the farm. That is a smart, smart transition of a farming operation. It's not happening enough, but it's starting to happen on the prairies.